It is now Monday the 17th of September 2018. And I've come to bother you again because I am calling. This is the thing I do. I bother you again every Monday. I've been thinking about paradoxes of consent, if you know what I mean. Consent means that you're not being forced to do something. Let's say you consent to a certain action. It means there's no coercion involved. But assuming it's informed consent and you know what you're getting into. Now, this can apply to a lot of things, but one of the reasons why I think about it is because it has everything to do with sexual harassment, which is something that civilized people try not to do to each other. Different people have different kinds of sensitivities to harassment. So if you made yourself completely 100% hermetically sealed from offending anyone, you would be kind of paralyzed. But it's not that hard to avoid being an asshole, I think. I could be wrong, but I think that one could make a small effort to not be an asshole. But there are paradoxes involved where... think about this. I have this problem in my mind where I believe that if you perceive beauty and never tell anybody about it, then that's kind of a crime. So, for example, if you see somebody who's beautiful and you never let them know that you think they're beautiful, they might go to their grave never knowing that they were beautiful. And maybe you were the only one who thought they were. So this is something I felt quite strongly. However, you could also be saying that to the person who hears that like 30 times an hour because of maybe there's just enough other people who think that person is beautiful. And if you... it's not going to be that meaningful to that person if you say, oh, you're beautiful, I think you're pretty... So there's a paradox there. Also, situational, right? But one of the discussions about people catcalling women on the street, different places, it's more thought to be acceptable to yell out sexually suggestive things to women walking down the street. If you're not drunk, it's something you can avoid doing, I think. But on the other hand, you might have reason to say something to somebody, and that could be, let me put it this way. If you want permission to speak to someone, see, this would be consent, to talk to someone on the street, a stranger, if you wanted to ask permission to speak to them, say, is it all right if I talk to you, if I say something, then you're going to have the problem where by the time you ask for the consent, then you've already done the violation. So the only solution to that is just never talk to anybody, and that's not a real good solution either. You've got a paradox there where you should be ask permission to speak. Because the thing you say might be innocuous or it might not be, depending. I mean, the very fact that you speak to someone might be terrifying to that person, depending on their history. So you're stuck there because if you make sure that you're never going to hurt anybody by speaking to them, then you're kind of you're dehumanizing yourself and them, really contributing to the to the people not talking to each other in the street phenomenon, which has never been a good thing. So these are the paradoxes. These are some of the paradoxes involved with not being coercive, with attempting to not be coercive, which is the core of anarchy. And now, so I've had that on my mind. And then there's the other things that have been happening is that it's quite busy around here lately because in Amsterdam, the IBC convention was the television people, I think it's International Broadcast something. Has brought a lot of people to town, including some of my friends who are visiting, like Barry and Anna, and other people. Also, Nicole has been in town, and Jokes and Joanna have returned yesterday. I mean, they've returned from a year-long journey around the world. A lot of us gathered together at the bar to greet them, and that meant I got to see a lot of my other friends, too. So it's been pretty busy around here, and Kuzelich, I want to say. I have been making progress on the novel about the girl with two goats. It's getting scary because I think I'm coming close to the climax. Well, maybe not the climax, but one of the big things that has to happen. And that's it. Now I'm going to smoke a cigarette. Okay, find the Alvin Ferder.